to Moravia Presbyterian Church's dinner theater. It's not as much of a theater as we had anticipated at first, but I think you will enjoy the music and hope that you will all join along. I do want to announce and invite you to our Christmas Eve service. It is at December 24th at 5 p.m. here. And now we will do the lighting of the Advent candle in just a moment.
Shall execute justice and righteousness in the land. In those days, Judah will be saved, and Jerusalem will live in safety. And this is the name by which it will be called: the Lord is our righteousness. Today we light this candle of hope. Watch and wait for Christ's coming, remembering the promises of God with prayer.
In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man named Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel came to her and said, "Rejoice, favored woman, the Lord is with you." But she was deeply troubled by this statement, wondering what kind of greeting this could be. Then the angel told her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Now listen, you will conceive and give birth to a son, and you will call his name Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give him the throne of his father David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and his kingdom will have no end." Mary asked the angel, "How can this be, since I have not been intimate with a man?" The angel replied to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. And consider your relative Elizabeth. Even she has conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month for her who was called barren."
Nothing will be impossible with God. "I am the Lord's slave," said Mary. "Mary, may it be done to me according to your word." Then the angels left her.
Sound of your greeting reached my ears, my baby leaped for joy inside me. She who has believed is blessed because what was spoken to her by the Lord will be fulfilled.
Everything inside me cries for orders. don't be afraid, for look, I proclaim to you good news of great joy that you will be for all the people. Today, a Savior who is Messiah, the Lord, has born for you in the city of David.
This will be a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped snugly in a cloth and lying in a feeding trough. Suddenly, there was a multitude of the heavenly host with the angel praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and peace on earth to people he favors." When the angels left them, he returned to heaven. The shepherds said one to another, "Let's go straight to Bethlehem and see what has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." They hurried off and found both Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the feeding trough.
After seeing them, they reported the message they were told about the child, and all who heard it
But Mary was treasuring up all these things in her heart, meditating on them. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had seen and heard, just as they had been told.
Thank you. rejoice and sing to you with gladness, for you have renewed us by your love. Restoring the fortune of the lost, gathering up the broken and despised, and giving them a home in glory. Through Christ Jesus and by the gifts of the Holy Spirit, you have made us children of Abraham and Sarah, calling us to live with faithfulness, justice, and compassion. Guard our hearts and our minds by the power of Christ Jesus. Speak to our anxieties with peace that passes all understanding, and let our gentleness and joy be a sign of Christ's gracious presence. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Tonight we are going to have communion, and we will participate in it by intinction. This is a symbolic act of our willingness to come to Christ. This isn't something to be done lightly, but it is a time of joy and celebration and remembrance. While historically it has been taught that only the baptized are able to take communion, the church has rethought this. And when Christ never refused anyone, we also do not refuse. However, it is not to be taken lightly. I want to take a moment as we sit quietly and make peace with our Lord, because the scriptures teach us that we are never to come to the table unworthy. So let us take a moment and confess our sins before our Lord. Is by the very act of Jesus' crucifixion, his death, and his resurrection that we are able to participate in this meal. And because of what he has done, his saving grace and work of the cross, we are able to participate and be his brothers and sisters. So be at peace knowing that you have been forgiven of all your sins. If you have not received baptism and you are wanting to do so, there will be a time after the service that you can speak to me about it. But you are welcome. This isn't just a Presbyterian table. Everyone is welcome to the table of Christ. And children, at the discretion of the parents, are invited as well. But the parents are to direct their own children. So on the night that Jesus was arrested, he took the bread and he gave thanks to the Lord, and he broke it and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And in the same way, he took the cup, saying, "This cup is the new covenant, sealed with my blood, shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this in remembrance of me." Every time you eat of this bread or you drink of this cup, you proclaim the saving death of our Lord Jesus Christ until he comes again. I would invite you to come forward after we get set and receive of the Lord.
Thank you.
forth in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Do so as you rejoice in the Lord. You rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say rejoice. The Lord is near. Hallelujah. Amen.